Mr. Francis Lincoln, one of the few old-timers left in the village of Tununak, Alaska, recalls the days of old as he eyewitnessed the Eskimo culture in progress. The Eskimo culture has evidently survived many centuries of primitive living without a self-written history of its own. Telling some stories of the past, like Mr. Lincoln here, has been the Eskimo's only means of passing his history down from the old to the younger generation of time. However, the fact that this is an era of the generation gap, today's young and old have ceased to communicate with one another about the subject of Eskimo cultural beliefs. Only a few are aware of the fact that much about the Eskimo cultural heritage is being forgotten and is about to be forgotten here at the end of the 20th century. Out of this forgetful period, how much of the Eskimo cultural heritage is going to survive? For those of you who do not realize the importance of a native cultural heritage, it might help to ask yourself, what is an Eskimo? What is it like to be without a cultural knowledge with which to identify as a living human race? Who is an Eskimo without the cultural supports to be recognized for what he is? At this modern age, the dying period of the Eskimo cultural heritage, something is being done to oppose the deterioration of young and old Eskimos of today and the future. The reconstruction of a century-old native Eskimo multipurpose sod house in the village of Tununak is the concerned villagers' hope to preserve some of the traditional values for future generations to come. The sod house of this size, used for this purpose, is called Kashem. In the days of old, the Kashem was the center of village activities. It was the place where men slept, ate, and worked. It was the place where the medicine man practiced and performed his unbelievable powers, and village dances and celebrations took place. Today, the Kashem is rapidly vanishing from the Alaskan Eskimo villages. One reason is that the native Eskimo has long since moved out of his traditional sod house and into frame houses. So in Eskimo villages where the entire population lives in frame houses, community halls made of lumber have taken the place of the Kashem. This has become the accepted way of any Eskimo community. Once they have accepted a new way or a new thing, the old ways become forgotten. So as for this Kashem, it has been left alone 3 years to be demolished by time, aging, and the destroying process. Today, new life has been given to this old Kashem in hopes that it will live well into the 21st century, carrying with it the information about Eskimo culture of the past to the future generations yet to come. Upon the completion of the kashem, a traditional potluck dinner was held. Each family donated their favorite food. After the feast, a dedication ceremony was held, followed by some traditional dances.
You got extra pluck?
I'm going to go to the house. Yeah.
This is the same village 4 years later. Many changes have occurred, such as new housing and a road. But there are many more changes yet to come. The 4 years of changes have proven that as long as the older generation exists, the Eskimos' cultural heritage will continue to exist.